Hello, it's David Tucker, and welcome to AWS This Week. It has been another week filled with AWS updates, and I have a handful that I think you will be interested in. These announcements will help you scale your containers, ingest events in a fault-tolerant manner, and even control who has access to your data warehouse. Interested in learning more? Well, you will get all the specifics after we roll the intro. To the news! Oh, and while you're here, if you want to keep up to date with that news, hit the subscribe button below. AWS Fargate has gained some scaling superpowers in 2022, and AWS has finally released the specifics. As a reminder, Fargate is AWS's serverless container compute service that lets you deploy your containers without managing any of the underlying infrastructure. According to AWS, the service can now launch up to 500 tasks in under a minute, which is 16 times better than last year. Now, in addition, they also announced that Fargate customers running on EKS, which is the AWS managed service that runs Kubernetes, can now see a 20 times improvement. Now, with these improvements, applications that see rapid spikes in request or background processing inputs can now leverage Fargate, where in the past it simply may have not been able to keep up. Now, one of the best things about this update is that it should be completely transparent to you. If you set a service's desired count to a number that requires massive scaling, you should see those improvements automatically. Check the link in the description to read about how all of this is working behind the scenes. Now, few integration services have changed the way event-based applications are built on AWS more than EventBridge. And with the ability to handle events that come from within AWS as well as outside of AWS, it helps us all build modern modular applications. AWS has recently made it better by introducing the global endpoints feature for EventBridge. With this feature, there is now a seamless way to create more fault-tolerant event-driven applications. A global endpoint will enable you to have failover between regions for event ingestion if your primary region is not available. Now, this feature also provides optional replication, which can handle replicating events from your primary to secondary event bus or back to your primary from the secondary in the event of an outage. This is yet another resource that AWS is providing developers for creating fault-tolerant cross-region solutions with Amazon EventBridge. Now, one of the key aspects of data governance is making sure that you can configure the right access to your data, and AWS is making it easier to leverage specific roles to configure access for Amazon Redshift. With this new capability, admins can use one of the four included roles or even create custom roles that grant access to perform actions on their data warehouse. If used properly, it should be easier to create access that is customized for a user or group of users. So in short, you don't have to give everyone super user access to your data warehouse any longer. That's it for this week, and no matter what you do in AWS, I believe you can find something to be excited about in this week's announcements. If you have any comments or questions, let us know in the comments. Now, see you next week, and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.